Maximilian Günther is Formula E's newest and youngest race winner. In his second season and only his third race for BMW iAndretti Motorsport, the 22-year-old cemented himself as a championship contender. Günther followed a conventional road to Formula E. He competed in three seasons in European Formula 3, beating future Formula 1 star George Russell to second in the championship in 2016. He progressed to Formula 2 in 2018 and scored his first podium in only his second race, followed by a victory at Silverstone halfway through the season. He finished 24 points ahead of his teammate despite missing the last two races in Abu Dhabi to focus on his switch to Formula E. JOX Dragon brought Günther on board to partner Jose Maria Lopez for the 2018-19 season. With 2 years of Formula E experience under his belt, Lopez was expected to beat his rookie teammate while Günther learned the ropes. But in the third race of the season in Santiago, the German outqualified Lopez and was running in an impressive sixth position, but stopped with a technical issue. Despite showcasing his skills so early in the season and in such uncompetitive machinery, Günther was replaced for the next round by Felipe Nasr. The Brazilian, in his first single-seater race since 2016, was last across the line in Mexico City, crashed out in Hong Kong, taking both Mahindra cars with him, and retired with a technical problem in Sanya. A clash with the IMSA Sports Car Championship meant that Nasr was unable to attend the next E-Prix, so Günther was back in the car in Rome. He wasted no time putting his JOX Dragon into Super Pole, starting fifth on the grid. An early mistake, followed by two time penalties, dropped him down the field to an eventual 19th place. It was a disappointing return, but Günther was given another chance to impress when Dragon announced that Nasr would be skipping the Paris E-Prix as well in order to focus on his IMSA campaign. This time, Günther made the most of the opportunity, qualifying 7th and climbing to 5th in a rain-soaked race. Nasr did not return, allowing Günther to see out the remainder of the season. Another 5th place finish at the Swiss E-Prix brought his points tally up to 20, whilst his teammate languished with only 3. Despite his lack of experience and the 3-race hiatus, he established himself as the more valuable driver and put himself in the shop window for other teams. When Antonio Felix da Costa made a shock move to DS Chichita, BMW iAndretti Motorsport needed a new driver to fill his seat. Günther was the man they went with. His first two races in Diria were disappointing. Despite standing on the podium in race 2, he was demoted to 11th after receiving a penalty for overtaking under the safety car. Meanwhile, his teammate Alexander Sims took his maiden victory. Günther headed to Santiago with a race-winning car beneath him, but 0 points to his name. After qualifying on the front row, the pressure was on to deliver a good result. He had to fight for it all the way to the checkered flag, but with a last-lap overtake, Maximilian Günther won in Santiago. He now sits fourth in the championship, having proven his potential to fight at the sharp end of the grid. But it'll take more than a few inspired one-off performances to win the Formula E championship. Can he deliver the consistent points finishes required to fight for title glory? Tune in to the CBMM Niobium Mexico City E-Prix on the 15th of February to see if Günther can take it to the max.